sir, for the records, may we have your
name? Dr. Ferdinand Anikwe. Well, if you listen to our address carefully, you would have known that we are recounting this man's genuine passion and commitment for the promotion and development of culture and culture-related programs in the sector from the time he was a military head of state till now. But in addition to this, we saw a singular contribution among the entire black world by his genuine interest in ensuring that there is unity across the entire African continent and our brothers, the blacks in diaspora. What we are saying today is that a careful planning of African leaders would have made everything in culture sector a money spinner. We felt that a lot of legacies, many things he tried to create. When you are in government, you'll be doing your best. You may not know how fight can reverberate. I want to take an example with the Festac town in Lagos, a town that emerged as a result of the fact that many Africans are coming for a cultural program. That town was born. Managing that town purely on its residential value and again being a tourist center would have been enough to contribute a very interesting quota for the development of Nigerian national economy. But many Nigerians have always fallen behind when you are talking about proper management. Good things have been done by several governments, but we are unable to maintain most of these. And we think that Nigerian leaders, we spend just a little fund, little money, to make sure that we harness and develop what God has given to us. The heritage side, creative economy, is the center of many economies all over the world, even those that are not naturally endowed. But Nigeria has everything any country can have on earth. So why don't we close our eyes from oil and see what God has given to us? This presidential library alone is enough to attract the whole world here. So, but we don't manage how to make money from tourists coming to this place because we didn't regard it as anything. We've always rested on oil. So we are now saying that these heritage programs we have can be carefully harnessed and a lot of money realized from it. What we try to show by showing the relics of Festac is to tell you a beautiful idea that was planted in 1977, which has blossomed into a very powerful image for Nigeria everywhere. I am the president of Pan-African Cultural Congress Bureau. It was just that I addressed a press conference at Addis Ababa, and I spoke on two things. One was Festac, the other one was Nollywood from Nigeria. The members of the bureau sat back and elected me president after I had flown back to Nigeria. So what I'm saying is that we merely recognize the origin of a lot of passion in culture, which Obasanjo has displayed. All we need to do is to harness and transform this into a money-yielding venture. There are several ways we can do that. Cultural tourism, ecotourism, and what have you. So we urge all Nigerian leaders, the governors, to look inwards in their own various states and local governments, find out cultural programs, be able to expand them. There was this drum festival here in Abeokuta last year. It was a fantastic thing. There is a mob festival in Enugu. There is a Arugungu festival in Kebbi State. You see what is happening in Cross River, in Calabar. There are many things that Oshun-Oshobo Festival, we can transform these to world centers of excellence, and we make a lot of money from it.